Hey guys, AndreasXP here, and today we are playing Oxygen Not Included again, episode number 5, I think. And today is going to be a very important day for our fellow duplicants, because today we are once and for all going to fix the problem of oxygen forever. True story, bro. Never is actually fixed forever in clay games, learn that, kids. But as you can see here in the oxygen thing, it's really getting out of hand. Like, I need to fix this quickly, because if this flows up, it's going to cover my research station, which is going to essentially stop my research. Then it's going to flow even higher to the storage things, then it's going to flow higher up into to the cots. Oh, that would be the best. When people start suffocating in their beds, that's when the colony goes to shit. Like, that's one rule I figured out playing this game. So, a couple of things changed since I last showed you this. First of all, it's cycle 18 now. It was, I think, 13 or 14 last time I left. If you remember, I told you guys that in the next episode, this episode, I will get all the resources ready so we can build a water purifying cycle with contaminated water and clean water cycling through. And we are going to do that today, although the research is not quite ready. I researched these two things, which are very important, haven't done much in this one, but while the guys research it, we can do something else. Because we don't have really a lot of stuff on our base. I mean, we have cots, right? We have oxygen, maybe some research station, a couple of algae generators, but that's mainly it. What we need is we need a heavy power source first. And second, we need a shit ton of pipes. That's what we need. What is happening? Pineapple pizza is breaking stuff? Wow, pineapple pizza. What a way. I think she's really stressed. Pineapple pizza stress is at 67%. Well, I wanted to deconstruct this anyway, so I guess thanks, pineapple pizza. Okay, well, let's work that out first, I guess. There's a thing in the furniture department called the message table. It appears to reduce the stress by quite a bit. So I'm going to build one over here, and I also need a couple of cots here and here. I'm going to remove it later, maybe place it in another place. Okay, get on that. And we'll assign that to Pineapple Pizza and she'll get a vacation, sure. If she's so stressed, I mean, yeah. This thing, this pool, while we're at it, looks very square. Look at this. I don't know, it kind of, it somewhat, somehow makes me feel uncomfortable. Everything is so not square in this game. Like, there's, the generation is just so bizarre that I never actually seen a rectangle in this game before. Anyway, back to the topic. So, what is a purifying cycle? It's a cycle of pipes where contaminated water gets cleaned to clear water then gets used in your machines, toilets, whatever, and becomes contaminated water again, which goes back into the cycle. So let's assign this to Pam, since she's our new girl and she haven't had a bed for like 4 days. First things that you need to have for that is actually contaminated water. And I've been looking at a couple of places here. There's contaminated water in this biome, over here, quite a bit actually, in here. This is all gas, and this. Laid my eyes on this big pool. Just compare this one to this one, and to this one. I think there's more water in this one than in these two combined. So we are essentially going to double our water supplies. There's a problem though. How are we going to get into that pool? Like, I need to build a pump on the bottom of the pool, right? To get the water out. The search is complete. Did I? No, that's the other one. Right, you need to jump into the pool to build a pump on the bottom, but the pool actually, its top touches the basalt, which I am not going to mine. because it's nearly impenetrable, as the tooltip says. I'm going to talk about a little bit about Abyssalite later, but not right now. So we need to do something else. And what I've come up with, I've been considering different options. For example, a double airtight seal, so you come through one door, the door closes, you come through the second door. But I think the best solution for that would be to dig a little tunnel over here, so that the water just drains down into this pool over here, and then what we need to do is just to build a pump on the bottom of this pool. And that will be it. So hopefully that works out for me. That's why I built this corridor here. It's all filled up with carbon dioxide, obviously. I'll place an airtight seal. I did a research specifically for that. If only I can find it. The manual airlock, it's called, yes. Place it maybe over here, because then then the slime starts, and I want to slime start after I place the manual airlock. So maybe over here, yeah, over here perhaps would be good. Another thing I would add is an air deoxidizer, because it's not only contaminated water in here, it's also contaminated oxygen, which is very toxic, as the tooltip says. And if the door opens and for a fraction of a second oxygen comes out, it's a contaminated one, I want to filter it out with the air deodorizer, not deoxidizer. I have like a couple of those over here and over here, just because I had a couple of yellow spots, yeah. Just so I don't get them into my base. So there's that. Somebody's stressed. Pineapple pizza, yes, because I wanted to assign this to her. Pineapple pizza. Please go to that. We'll put that on sticks. So she prefers that over everything else. Hopefully now she'll get less stress. Look at her face. It's just... I mean, it is the face you make when you have a massage. Maybe not with wooden hands, but... it's just funny, I like it. Okay, what was I talking about? Yes, this. So, after we build this airlock, I want them... I actually want to prioritize this, so they don't take an eternity to build it. Let's build a tunnel over here. Here's where we can build our purifiers and stuff like that. Then I want a ladder down to the bottom of the lake, because somehow I need to build a pump there, you know. How's the guys doing? The guys are doing well. This thing is still not covered with carbon dioxide. I have unbelievable luck in that regard. Okay, so they're building it. Then down here, I want to have a pump to pump out water, which is over here. Why can't I place it here? Oh, I can't place it on a ladder, partially. Oh, I didn't know that. Okay. From that, we want a pipe to go up, like this. We'll connect it to the purifiers later. And I think it also requires electricity. Yes. So we'll run an electric wire all the way up to here. Okay, so electric wire is all cool, but oh, we actually have a new duplicate. Didn't know that. Let's choose that first. Okay, so obviously this one. This guy is good. Yes, this one is the best. Okay. Right? Melody. Beautiful name. We'll rename it to some pizza name later. Right, we're using energy with the pump. It actually requires quite a bit of energy. But how do we supply that energy? The answer is coal generator. And I'm going to do that over here, where I planned it. You see, there's a spot left. The thing with coal generator, first of all, it's very hot. So I don't want the hot temperature to spread from the coal generator. The second thing is that it emits carbon dioxide a lot. So I want to block that as much as possible. So I'll build a manual airlock here and some tiles like that. Then I want the actual call generator. In fact, I think I want two call generators because I can, just like that. I want to dig out this stuff because this is coal, and I want to. I think that's it. Let's wait until they do that. I want this to be done first and this to be done first. If possible, okay. So we're building a coal generator. Wires are already in place, that's good. How are we doing? Oh, we build the air deodorizer. It will filter out contaminated air, hopefully. The water is getting pretty low. We already took like a whole roll of water. So I want to start cleaning it pretty soon. Now, the water cycle. Why do I need it? Why do you need it? If you came to here to watch it as a tutorial, sure, why not? But why do you need a water cycle? Well, probably because you want to get some good oxygen, and for that you want to get an electrolyzer, which I don't have raw metal for. Well, we'll mine it soon. So the electrolyzers, they take clean water and convert it to oxygen, but the clean water that you get over here and over here is not nearly enough. Okay, stop with the explanation. I'm thinking of myself as a teacher here, but I always hated teachers for reasons known to everybody. Okay guys, so I advanced a little bit in our great task, but people are starting to get idle, so we are going to build a couple of more things together and hopefully they'll take their time and finish this. I almost built all the generators, I only have one generator left. I filled the floor with tiles, I got the wires. Actually, I don't think I got all the wires. Yeah, I need a bit more over here. This room is getting way hot, look at this. That's why I put an airtight seal here, and the coal generators will also start to produce stuff very soon. So while people are doing stuff, there are 4 idle people, that's crazy. I'm going to just go ahead and build some oxygen generating machines. So first ones are air scrubbers. Air scrubbers filter carbon dioxide and remove it from the air completely. So these are the ones that I want to build here. Oh, there's a plant here. Jesus Christ, how did I not notice that? Okay, we'll build maybe a couple of more. Oh, there's also a plant there. Jesus Christ. Okay, I'll build 2 right now, because plants are apparently a big thing in this town. So these air scrubbers, they first of all require power, so let's do that. But that's the boring thing. The interesting thing is the pipes, the plumbing. So they have intakes. They intake good water, so we will maybe run a pipe down here like that. Or actually, the good water will come from the cleaners, right? Okay, so let's build a good pipe over here. And Jesus, give me a sec. By good pipe, I mean the pipe that transports clean water. It will run horizontally like that. And then they output dirty water. So we'll run a bad water pipe up here. Okay. You might ask, why do I need to run a bad water pipe to here? Isn't there enough bad water, contaminated water already? Well, the answer is simple. You have to get that water somewhere, and it's a logical thing to just dump it in the same tank it came from. So that's good. Now, that's the air scrubbers that remove carbon dioxide. Now I need electrolyzers, which will generate oxygen. Luckily for me, they don't get hot, so I can just build them on my base and not really worry about it. I'll build 3, because 3 is a lucky number for me, for some reason. They're already connected, that's good. And the only thing they need is a supply of clean water. This is where things get tricky though. Because you can't just cross pipes, they'll just mix. I have this liquid pipe bridges, but you can't place them everywhere. You can only place them where there's nothing else, like here, for example. So that's good. Worked out for me very well. Now we just run it along the ladder like this, and we got our connections. They'll go ahead and build that. Now here, I only have the bed pipe, right, from the pump that gets the bed pipe water. And that's good, but I also want the good pipe, and for that I'll need a liquid vent. So, like that, for example. I think that's too low, right? Might be. What I mean by too low is that when I let this water flow down here, it'll probably fill this whole thing up. So I guess we'll hold on that liquid vent, and we'll see where the water settles first. This thing I want to build, obviously, so the water gets through. How are guys doing? This is sixth priority, and they are still building the other thing. For some reason, not sure how that works. Okay, this is our first air scrubber. Still isn't connected, but we are working on that. This granite is really hard to penetrate. It's unfortunate that we have to build a ladder here, but I don't think there's anything we could do about that. Now, to clean the water, we need the refinement water purifier. Those are easy to organize. What we need is, first of all, we need, I guess, two of them, because two is better than one. So they input dirty water that's coming from this pipe, right? We'll do it. How do we do it? I'm not sure. I guess we'll just do it from the top like this. And the output clean water which will just go into the pipes there. Okay, so that is connected, I think. If I didn't mess up, it all should be connected. How are you guys doing? How is my... Oh, you can see it's getting bad. The computers are filled up. It's good that I completed my resources, but we need to work on that right now and very quickly. Did we dig up the plant here? We did not. We should do that, so we can build another air scrubber there. How are guys doing? What are you working on? This guy is on the toilet. Okay, I can tolerate that. This girl is eating. Somewhat. Not really. This girl up is pumping water into the Algaium terrariums that don't work, so I'll mark those for deconstruction, so she doesn't waste her time. I am having a little bit of a trouble, if you would care to ask. This super hard granite and igneous rock that I was talking about is not that hard, actually. In fact, it is so not hard that it got penetrated and by the contaminated water, and now it's flooding my whole basement. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to lower the lower part of the ladder building, and I'm going to prioritize this. And I have two people idle again. What the fuck is wrong with you guys? I guess I'll ask you to mop these things out, right? Something to do. So yeah, we need to let this water flow down as fast as possible, because otherwise it's going to flood the whole thing here, and I don't want to think about how I'll fix that one. But I think we're pretty close. There's only there's no hard materials left, so we break this, and this will hopefully flow down. Come on, still not slowing down because there's still gold anagram left. Come on, guy. Dig it. Come on. Come on. Oh my goodness, this is bad. Look at how much stuff we're getting here. Please, please just dig it. Oh, finally. Okay, we stopped it. It's all good. Jesus Christ, that's a mess. Okay, we'll fix that soon enough. Jesus Christ. The great flood had started way before I anticipated it to go. Just a whole giant mess. Okay, I'll clean this. Hopefully no more will fall down. Yeah, when I dig this tunnel out, it will just bump down really, really quickly. And that's what I'm counting on. Yeah, see, it's filling up very quickly. I have a lot of water, it's just a matter of handling it, you know? How are we doing on other stuff? How are we doing on our oxygen? It's filling up, it's getting a little bit on the, you know, difficult side. But the water is pumping. The water is pumping, that is good. Now that we dug this out, we can prioritize this. More people get to work. Nice, nice. Okay, this is now going full speed down into the down thing. Oh, we get a new duplicant, that's great. Just in time. You have a great opportunity to show your skills at cleaning up liquid messes that we create. Now, who do we choose? This one has a decor expedition minus 15, so that's very tempting for me. This two have 15. Digging, digging, plus medicine, plus learning. This can't dig anything, but he has digging. Also has athletics and tinkering. I think I'll pick up this one, because they're all somewhat the same. They're good at digging, but that's... if that's the only trait they have, it's not worth it. I'll pick you, because you're not picky. Pun intended. Now, the guys are almost finished building the pump. When the pump is done and all wires are connected, these things are not going to start to run because they don't have anywhere to output their contaminated water because we haven't finished this pipe. These things will start to run though, so that's good. One thing I want to talk about is that we can't connect this bad pipe to this bad pipe. Because this bad pipe goes from the machines and this one goes from the pump. There is always going to be water in this one. And what can happen is that there's always water in this one. It's like standing in a queue to get purified, right? Then water, dirt water from this pipe arrives and it's like, I have nowhere to go. It's all, yeah, see, it started to go. That's beautiful. It's all queued up. I can't fit there. And so the pipe will clog up all the way up to the machines and the machines will stop. And that's definitely not what I want. Let's see if the things start purifying. I really want them to start purifying right now. Oh, they need filtration medium. They need sand delivered to them. Well, my guys, Bertin and Goose, are doing that. Is that not enough? Still? Please start purifying. No? Okay, well, I guess we'll have to wait on that a little bit. We need more sand. This guy fall asleep right there. Is that safe? That's not safe at all. Okay, that's alright. We can fix that. We can fix everything. We only have 10 colonies to worry about. Yeah, about this pipe. So we need to do something else. The solution I think I'll use is separating this pipe. So instead of running this bad pipe to this bad pipe, we actually will run it to a liquid vent, which we'll position here maybe. I don't know, doesn't really matter, or here even. Right? And we'll run a liquid pipe to that using a bridge. So we'll put a bridge here. Oh, we can't put a bridge here, can't we? Can we? Because because if we put a bridge here, then we can't put anything on this tile and the thing will get suspended and won't work. Okay, I need to figure this out. This is very difficult. You could just run it on the top, right? But there's abyssalite here. There's two whole tiles of abyssalite, and I'll spend an eternity digging that. I'll probably, my whole colony will die before I dig that two pieces of abyssalite. So we need to come up with something else. What can we do? Is there a free spot? There is a free spot over here. So what if we do liquid pipe? Do liquid pipe over here, so we run this to this pipe, then we run this like that, okay, up to here, then we will deconstruct liquid pipe in these places, okay, just managed to make it work, now we are deconstructing it. Oh, Jesus. Put a bridge like that, okay, and then run a pipe through the bridge like this, perfect, okay. And if I'm right, this will work, and let's put all that to 6 so they get on that immediately. Let's put that actually to 7, because if this works, we are saved. I mean, if that works in time. How are guys doing? How's... It's not doing well. It's so not doing well. What are you doing here? Why are you opening the door? Don't open the door. There's toxic stuff there. Come on, guys. Chop chop. We don't have a lot of oxygen to waste. Come on. Okay, okay, they're going. Full speed ahead. They're digging out. They're digging out. That's good. This gets suspended, but we can put tiles here. We can hide piping in the tiles. That's all right. We can do that much. We need to connect this to a pipe and this to a pipe and put that to 7 as well. Come on, almost done. Okay, pipes are in place. Now let's place the flooring. Like that. This is really tight spaces. I need to manage that very, very carefully, so I don't fuck up. Okay. Oh, it started working. It started working. Let's switch to normal speed to see how it works. Okay, it's outputting clean water. It's going to the through the down pipe. It's good. How's the other one? The other one is working too. Great. Oh my goodness. Is this actually going to work? I'm surprised. For some reason this isn't connected, I forgot about that one. Let's prioritize this to 7. Okay. It's outputting. Yes, okay. It's splitting up over here. Bunch of it is going to the air dioxide, the old air scrubbers actually, sorry. They started working, okay. Somewhat. They still don't have a lot of water. So they'll start removing air here, and the electrolyzers will start pushing air up. Okay. Great. Oh, I thought that would never work. Jesus Christ. I think we are saved. I think it's just a matter of time before we clean all this carbon dioxide and we can do research and all the other fun stuff again. Okay. Now, we need to start building other stuff. People are standing idle here. You see? You see this? It's outputting hydrogen. is the electrolyzers outputting hydrogen? Is this what I've been searching for all this time? There is definitely hydrogen. Maybe, oh, you know, now that I think about it, in real life, electrolyzer is, it splits water, H2O, into oxygen and hydrogen, right? Oxygen is what we breathe, and hydrogen is what we use to generate energy. Now I understand. How was I so foolish? How did I not understand that? Wow. Okay, I think I've just learned something very interesting about science in general, and this in particular. And people are really standing idle. Okay, so that makes me rethink my whole strategy with this game. So, like, what I mean is, we need to get rid of hydrogen somehow, alright? To get rid of hydrogen, we need to use hydrogen. And we can only use hydrogen in the hydrogen generator, which isn't bad, I mean. But I never used it. So what I'm thinking is, we build a plant on the very top of the world, if you want. Like maybe right here. Just ding this out like that, okay? We'll build a hydrogen generator on there, and under it we'll build the electrolyzers. So hydrogen is lighter than oxygen, so it will rise up, get absorbed, and worked through the hydrogen generator, and then we'll just have infinite energy forever, as long as we have water. I think that's good. I think we just fixed it. Wow. Didn't think that would be too easy. But it was, actually. So, okay. The flooring can't be just tiles, now that I think about it. It needs to be gas tiles, because from below, the hydrogen will come. Okay? And, actually, not this one, because here we'll build a manual airlock. With a tile above, and with a deodorizer. Oh, we don't actually need the deodorizer there, because it's not going to produce any contaminated oxygen. And a tile like this. Okay. I think that's good. Let's put a wall here. And let them build it. Okay, nobody is idle, that's good. Nobody is in this room, which is also very good, because it's very, very toxic. I don't have a lot of oxygen here. This thing need to work and work quickly. But you see, they are removing oxygen here. We get pieces of vacuum that immediately get absorbed. And these things work like crazy and emit oxygen. Yeah, you see, we are getting some dense oxygen there. Why is people idle again? Like, we have so much to do. Come on, guys. Don't be like that. Nice. I think that's solid. I think we just worked out the whole thing. Pretty much. Okay. We might purify this place a bit more later, but that's, you know, later. Not right now. I'm just happy the thing works. Somebody's suffocating. What the fuck? Who? Where? Oh, Pam got stuck. What the hell? Guys, could you free her up, please? Please? Guys? Somebody? Right now. Pam. What the fuck, Pam? Please, for the love of God, don't do that again. Get to safety and breathe right now. Jesus Christ. Yeah, I guess the things happen. Who is suffocating again? Pam? Pam, don't suffocate. Breathe. Wait. Regain your oxygen. Jesus Christ. I can only imagine what kind of levels of stress I'll get after this mission. Mozzarella, can you please maybe get out of here? Do you really think that's a good place to build stuff? Jesus fucking Christ, you guys. Okay, I need to calm down. Now, Now for the base. We need gas tiles here because oxygen, because we'll generate oxygen here. So I think I'll build the same pattern like this. And we don't actually need an airtight seal here too. Oh, we do actually need, because we'll get hydrogen, yes. If you're confused by the words I am spitting out, then don't be, because I'm going to explain everything very soon. And I actually already explained it once, so it shouldn't be hard to understand what I'm doing right now. And here, later, we'll build the, we'll rebuild our air, our electrolyzers. Okay. So in here, what are we doing in here? This is pretty important, I think. How are we doing? Oh, they're sucking up. Oh, they're probably starving for air because of these tiles. I need to deconstruct those. Temporarily. Like this. Okay, somebody go deconstruct, please. Thank you. Now here, the generator, right? The generator is right here. So we will build that. Like that. It requires a wire, so we'll do that too. Connect it to our main wireframe. Now, it needs to get hydrogen input, alright? So what we do is we get a... Where is it? Give me a sec. Plumbing? A gas pump, right, that will get gas from here. Do we need to put it up here or do we not? Probably we do, right? Let's build it up here. It will output gas, run it down, then we'll have a gas filter. So this will filter out everything except hydrogen. Like this, okay, and everything except hydrogen will just go somewhere else, I guess. Like, I don't know where. Here, maybe, like this, and we'll put a gas vent over here. Okay, so that should be good too. Yeah, we are getting a lot of hydrogen here. Hopefully that won't suffocate my guys. Did we deconstruct? We did deconstruct, that's good. However, they're sucking up pretty good. Yeah, I think we're effectively getting rid of all the carbon dioxide. Maybe one more cycle and we'll get a gas-free zone. Okay. Great, we can deconstruct this now. Finally, we can deconstruct this crazy thing. We can worry about other things, like actually good things now. For example, we can build a toilet. Where is it? We can build a lavatory, a liquid toilet, and so people don't have to use that shitty one. We can build it over here, for example. We can also build a shower, which is essentially the same as the toilet, in the sense that, not in the sense that you can pee in there, but I mean that you can you need to input clean water and output dirty water. Like that. Okay, but this is the first priority right here. And this one. But why are the coal generators not running? Is that something you guys do? By the way, look at this room. It's filled with carbon dioxide. If not for the airtight seal, it would be bad. Okay. This thing is a mess too. I have a shit ton of contaminated oxygen here. We need to fix that too. Oh, look at that. We already freed up the computers. These guys are really doing a good job, by the looks of it. Only thing I need is to get the coal delivery to the generators. This thing needs to get electricity. I can do that. Like that, okay. I think the episode is getting a little longer. a little bit longer. Okay, Gauss output all, filtered Gauss output, we will... Filtered Gauss is which Gauss? I'm sorry. Is that the one that goes through, or the one that stays? It's the purple one. Filtered Gauss output. So we'll filter out everything. How can we... Can we only filter one out? Oh, that's... Didn't think about that, did I? Okay, well, I guess we aren't going to get any more different oxygens. We are only going to get oxygen. Yeah. Okay. So hopefully this will work as I want it to work. Really hoping for that. These guys are escaping... Like, what the fuck, guys? Is that something you really want to do? There's not a lot of... Yeah, this oxygen is unbreathable, guys. You might want to go back inside. Can you do that for me? You too. Guys. Come on. Okay, she climbed up. Hopefully no one else will try to escape my crazy thing over here. Okay, so to get this hydrogen out of the place, somebody's suffocating. Pineapple pizza. Okay, everybody, I'm sorry, we need to go on red alert because somebody just got stuck in a gas vent. And if you can, let's prioritize this to... Super important, if you can. Come on, come on. Come on. Thank you. Now you can go to sleep. That was one big of a mess. And Melody just pissed herself. Somebody's suffocating. Who? Nobody. Pineapple pizza, because she can't breathe very well there. Anyway, guys, I think we've been going here for too long, but hopefully you found this Let's Play video / tutorial somewhat helpful. Because as you can see, we did fix our problem. The only thing that matters now is to get rid of the hydrogen that we are getting up, but I told you the decision for that too. I'll do the rest of this in the next episode, because I'm really getting tired of the bullshit this game has. How can you not tell me that you're emitting hydrogen out of the electrolyzers? That's just pure craziness. I don't know how they didn't tell me that. Anyway, guys, thank you for watching, that was AndreasXP, don't forget to like this video if you liked it, don't forget to dislike, maybe, if you disliked it. That was AndreasXP, and I'll see you in the next episode of Oxygen Not Included. Bye-bye.